Hello, everybody. Today, we're going to talk about removing backscatter from your images in post-production. Backscatter, backscatter. So frustrating. And backscatter is going to show up in some photos. You can have the best strobe positioning in the world, be the world's best strobe positioner. And you're still gonna get some backscatter, especially if you're shooting in thick, chunky, plankton-filled water. So most of us, pretty much all of us, have to remove some backscatter in post. Again, it depends on the water and what you're shooting, but there's going to be some removal. And there's two main ways to remove backscatter in post-production. The first is a spot removal tool in Adobe Lightroom. And a number of versions ago, Adobe built that in, inspired by the clone and heal brushes inside of Photoshop. They brought the tool into Lightroom and have since made it more strong, more robust, with better algorithms to help clean up the images, which is great for backscatter. And the second tool is the dust and scratches filter found in Photoshop. Now, I don't really use the dust and scratches filter in Photoshop. That's creating a huge layer and making a big global change for all the backscatter. And as a result, you're oftentimes going to get a softer image, even though you have gotten rid of a lot of backscatter. So for me personally, I never go there. I figure if there's that much backscatter, I just move on to the next image or figure out how to work with it. So this tutorial will focus real quickly on how to maximize your use of the spot removal tool in Lightroom. With Lightroom open, we're going to navigate to the Develop module, and then you'll see that I've got a previously edited image here. But no problem, for this tutorial, let's start with a new virtual copy. So I will right click, create virtual copy, and now I'm actually editing a virtual copy of the image. If we open up the menu here, you'll see that I am on copy one, which is not the original file. So that's good. So reset. And now you'll notice that we've got a number of backscatter particles that have popped up since this is the original version of the photo, straight out of camera, unedited, unproduced, you know, raw, just the way it was shot. And now it's time for the spot removal tool. So generally, I will go through all my editing process and do spot removal at the end once I know more of what I'm looking at. But for the purpose of this, you know, let's hit that cue, and now we've got our spot removal tool, and you'll see it right here on the screen. So we can adjust the size of the brush in any number of ways. We can grab this brush diameter slider right here, and we can adjust the size. We can also use the wheel on our mouse, if we're using a regular mouse, to adjust the size of the tool, or we can use the bracket keys on the keyboard. So experiment with all of those and see what's quickest for you as you're going through different pieces of backscatter to be able to remove the different pieces at just the right size. You don't want to select extra pixels if you don't have to. So what I'm going to do is start on the heal brush tool, and we'll explain both of these, but hit the Z key and zoom in. Now we can see a lot closer. You'll notice here in the navigator where I am in the frame. So let's move up to some of those taller pieces of backscatter. There we go, those two that I saw. So what I'm going to do is shrink the spot removal tool that is set to heal, and I can click, and now it's gone. I can click this other piece of backscatter, and now it's gone. And if you go to the tool overlay, click always, and here you go. You can see where this piece selected from. Adobe Sensei determined that was a good spot to sample from. And with the heal brush, what you're doing is telling Adobe to sample a group of pixels that it thinks will fit well in the area you have selected. So it's going to determine where it thinks it should select from, and then pick the best pixels to put in that spot, and it's going to intelligently fix the area you've corrected. But notice here in this case that it selected an area with another piece of backscatter right here. What you can do is just click and drag the selection area to somewhere else in the frame. And as long as you keep it close, that heal brush is going to read what's over there. And now I can just turn these off again. And here you go. So now I've selected a different area that won't pull more backscatter into the frame, which is great. So that's a benefit of the heal brush. I always keep it at 100% opacity because I want to get rid of that backscatter spot. There's nothing I'm trying to do that will keep any bit of backscatter in there. And I do feather to zero because the pixel samples are usually very good. There's no need to feather anything out. I want to take a full sample for the spot I've selected. And because I am determining the size of my spot in my piece of backscatter with the mouse or the keyboard or the slider, you know, I don't need to worry about feathering the effect at all. If you do find that you're on the edge or somewhere where you've got a piece of backscatter that's giving you trouble, let's try this one right here. And it's, you know, look at that. We just saw that the tentacle got erased because the sampling, I keep pulling up this bottom nav bar, The sampling just picked a bad spot here and it's not quite working. So what we can do is switch over to the clone tool. And the clone tool allows you to pick the exact representation for what you want to replace. Versus sampling pixels, the clone tool will exactly replace what you've selected. So if I say to put this piece right here, you'll notice that it's just picking this area that I selected. It just put that right there, different color water, different tentacle strand. It's an exact duplicate. So sometimes this is really useful when you're working around the edge on a border and Lightroom just can't figure out exactly what you're doing. But sometimes for something like this, you know, we've got tentacles in there, we might want to adjust finely with this clone brush and do something there because that's gonna be as close as we can get. And now we can turn off the preview and there's a little, you know, it's not quite, but it's a little better. So, you know, the clone tool would be good for that. It's good for edges and borders when you want the exact representation. And like with the heel brush, you can adjust the size, the feather, and the opacity. Mostly the size is what you're going to look at. One note about the spot removal tool in Lightroom is that it is good, but in Photoshop it is better. So if you do have a lot of tough spots, a lot of spots on edges you want to get rid of, send that into Photoshop. Export the photo into Photoshop, do the clone brush over there, the heel brush over there, and the algorithm just seems to work better. It's going to perform better around edges, create smoother, you know, pixel sampling, and it's going to produce a better backscatter removal if you ever find yourself in a challenge. Generally, I do all my backscatter removal in Lightroom, so I don't worry about it. It's only when there's something that's challenging, you know, that's the only time I'll go to Photoshop. So one last little tip to give you is if you go down here to visualize spots, let's zoom back out real quick. Look what it's going to do. So now we have this black and white version of everything that's going on, and these are all of my pieces of backscatter. So if you're really looking for this sort of help in terms of cloning out your backscatter, it looks like the night sky, right? You can see there's three pieces here, there's a couple here, there's a big one there, you know, four here that, you know, are gonna show up. They're not as big when you start looking at the real image, but some people really prefer to use the visualize spots tool to help remove some backscatter, because once you're here, you can just remove the piece of backscatter right like that. If I go back to heel, let's get rid of this one again. And now there you go, you've gotten rid of that piece of backscatter. So whatever way works for you is okay. I generally don't use the visualize spots, but a lot of people find it very useful. So no biggie. I hope that helps. And as always, send me your questions. You know what to do. And we'll get some more tutorials cooking for you guys. Talk to you soon.